Hello friends and family, and welcome to my channel. Today I took out a very overgrown Chinese elm from the bench, and intended to make a little bit of a haircut, summer pruning on it. This species has been some of a mysterium to me. Everywhere you read online it says they can be kept indoors and shouldn't go below 0 degrees Celsius, and could be grown in a windowsill, and but at the same time I have seen hundreds and thousands of dying Chinese elms on the internet forums, and all of them has been kept indoors. So yeah, maybe it's possible. If you're one of them that succeed keeping them indoors, please let me know in the comment. I live in a fairly cold climate, and what I did during the winter, I put them in the unheated part of my greenhouse. It was solid frozen in the soil for more than 6 weeks, and the lowest temperature it endured was minus 16 degrees. So, but when the frost released, it immediately dropped all its leaves in once. So actually I thought I had killed it, but as you can see, that was not the case. In spring I repotted this to a new pot, better to my liking, but I couldn't get the angle I want on the trunk. So just wait another year or two, and next time I will tilt it a little bit more. So yeah, first thing, weeds growing, always get the weeds off, make it look a little bit nicer. Before I prune, I think it would be fair to show you a picture how this tree was looking when I took it out on the bench this spring. So a clip coming up. So, let's start this. Here we have one, the second branch. It seems like it has been away from the sun. You can see it quite clearly here. This way has, this side has been away from the sun, and this one has been towards the sun. So we only want to prune the long leggy shoots and put it more back into control. And I think when I put it back on the bench, I put it with the other side facing the sun. So yeah, first branch. And when I cut, I look at where I want the silhouette of the tree to be. And that was a dead bumblebee, I think. Okay, so cut back to the silhouette I want to have, and pay attention to the direction of the last leaf, because that is the direction the new growth will take. This year I will try to keep a lot of the cuttings and see if I can root them. That should be interesting. So So this branch has been pruned back to a flat pad, and I'm going to continue all over the tree. I always take a step back, bow myself to the same height as the tree, and inspect what's going on. It's easier to do the right decisions then. I guess this is it for a summer pruning. I have been taking away a few minor branches going in the wrong direction that really should be done in winter, but just a few of them. So this is what we have after the pruning. While inspecting the tree, I also noticed that the wire holding the tree here is biting into the bark. So, and there's not much wire to it was possible to loosen, so I don't know the situation. I took quite a lot of roots. It's not wobbly in the pot, so should be okay. So after pruning, I take some it's a control release fertilizer that is not the same as slow release fertilizer. The control release fertilizer will release nutrition to the tree depending on temperature and moistness. So I find it really good for my tree. So since it the control release fertilizer is not that beautiful, I try to push them down a little bit into the soil and then just add a small surface layer, an extra topping on it. So I just gonna get my top layer and get back to you. So I have sifted out pieces of bark mulch. Just sift away the big pieces and the small pieces, and I add a thin layer of it. This is just for the extra little visual appearance. I am attending the Balding Reefer live stream Friday. I think it's 9 o'clock in Central European time and 8 o'clock in UK time. So I thought that I should have something, a nice looking tree behind me. So that's why I'm doing this work right now. This bark mulch is of course not necessary, but it makes it look a lot better. Okay, so last, let's do a last spin of the tree, ready for attending live stream on Friday. And of course, what is it now? Tuesday. It cannot be wet when it gets inside, so better give it a very good drink now and a very good drink tomorrow and full sun, and then we're ready. So please join me, Balding Reefer and Lampy Mallard, on the live stream on Friday. Thanks a lot for watching. Take care, stay safe, bye.